hello there once again out there in Facebook land. Hope you're having a great evening. This is our third little mini live online concert we've done this week, and we're going to continue doing it every night. Great to see all of you if you're tuning in once again. We've got a lot of music to share with you tonight. We're going to do actually a little bit of a longer concert for you tonight. And if you're watching this, feel free to leave a comment and say hello. You can tell us where you are, where you're listening from, whether you're in Rochester or maybe another city, state, or even country, different part of the world. Planet. We always love different planet. If you're watching from Mars or Saturn, please let us know because we'd love to figure out how to get there. So we'd like to start with a piece called The Continental, and this is a jazz standard that I actually first heard in a Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers movie, and they do a beautiful dance sequence to this song. It's probably the highlight of the movie. Close to the end, it's probably about a 20-minute long beautiful dance that they do together to this song, and that version actually inspired me to come up with my own arrangement of it. It's got some changing rhythms and different cool things going on, so we hope you enjoy our arrangement of The Continental. Thank you. was our arrangement of a jazz standard called The Continental. And hello to all of you listening out there. I can see on my my feed here that a couple people are tuned in. Thank you so much for joining us. Hope that you're all staying healthy still and taking good care of yourselves during this time. Next, we'd like to play an arrangement by the great pianist Fred Hirsch. And if I may, I'd like to just talk about Fred for a minute. He's a world-renowned pianist and composer and arranger, and I feel very, very fortunate to know him. I had a really lucky opportunity when I was in high school to have a piano lesson with him, and it was just before I was getting ready to do college auditions, and he was actually the person who recommended that I check out Western Michigan University, which is where I ended up going to school. So you could say that Fred single-handedly changed the course of my life, really, and I've just never forgotten that. And since I ended up studying there, I got to spend some time with him over the years as he came to do his artist in residence there. He was a visiting professor during that time. And he also was the one who connected me with Steve Zagree, the piano teacher at Western, which is another reason I ended up going to school there. So I'm just very grateful to have Fred Hirsch in my life. And if you haven't checked out his music, you absolutely should. And this is an arrangement that comes from an album he released several years ago. The album is called Floating. And this arrangement just knocked me out the first time I heard it. It's You and the Night and the Music, a jazz standard by the songwriting team Dietz and Schwartz. And this arrangement just reminds me so much of Johann Sebastian Bach, the way that he made kind of a counter melody between the left hand and the right hand. So I transcribed this arrangement. Hope we will do it justice. This is Fred Hirsch's arrangement of You and the Night and the Music.
Thank you.
That was Fred Hirsch's arrangement of You and the Night and the Music. It's so much fun to play. It's just so much fun. And it was such a fun challenge to learn. I shouldn't say it was a challenge to learn. It still is. Music is always a work in progress, but we just love playing that one so much. If you're just joining us, thanks so much for being here. Of course, we are Laura Dubin and Antonio Guerrero, and we so appreciate you spending your Wednesday evening with us. We'd like to play a Thelonious Monk composition now, and this has a great story behind it. This tune is called Evidence, and the reason that it's called Evidence is because it is based on the chords of a jazz standard called Just You, Just Me, and this is a little insight into how the brain of Thelonious Monk worked. So he got Just You, Just Me, and he turned that into Just Us, which sounds like the word justice. And his thinking was, if you have justice, or in order to have justice, you have to have evidence. That's how he arrived at the name of this tune. Hope you enjoy. Thank you. can't be in a bad mood after playing that tune. That was Thelonious Monk's Evidence. Hello to everyone who's just joining us. Feel free to leave a comment and say hello and let us know where in the world you are watching this from. And if you're enjoying it, feel free to share on your page just to spread the music around. The next one we'd like to play comes from our album called Classical Jazz, which we released about a year ago, actually exactly a year ago this month. And the album was exactly what it sounds like, our arrangements of classical music in a jazz trio style. And of all the pieces on that album, this seems to be the one that our audience has requested the most since we've begun performing it, and it's one of our favorites to play as well. This is our arrangement of Claude Debussy's Clair de Lune combined with Henry Mancini's Moon River. There's a little bit of a moon theme there.
Thank you.
that was our arrangement of Claude Debussy's Clair de Lune combined with Henry Mancini's Moon River. And I'd just like to take a moment to get on my Facebook here for a sec because I can see that some comments are popping up. So I just wanted to look through this video real quick and say hello to some of you out there. This is really fun figuring out how to use all this tech. Woo! Oh my gosh. So funny. Hey Joel, thanks for watching. Whoa, there's two of me. That's really trippy. I'm going to turn my volume down for a sec. Okay, there we go. Hi, Linda, Betsy, Brian, Cecile, Joel, Lisa, Clemen, Ma! Thank you so much for watching. Hola. It's Hola. Your mom. My mom's watching. Hey, both moms are here. Yay. Thank you so much for tuning in, everybody. We're so delighted that you're all here. Thank you so much for leaving some comments there. We really appreciate it. So that was really funny when my own talking showed up there. So we'd like to play an original composition next, and this is one of our newer ones. It's going to be released soon on our album of original music about Paris, which many of you have heard we've been working on. And this composition is called Louvre Groove. I just had to make a tune with that name because I just love that rhyme. The Louvre is, of course, a very famous art museum, possibly the most famous in the world. And you can find the Mona Lisa there, Venus de Milo, many famous works of art, but also hundreds of thousands more just as beautiful works of art. And we have a really funny story about when we went to the Louvre Museum when we were in Paris last summer, because as you can imagine, the Mona Lisa being like the most famous painting of all time, it's really, really hard to get in front of her just to even see her. And this past summer, they happened to relocate the painting to a different side of the museum for some reason. I think they were in the middle of making a new Da Vinci exhibit to celebrate his birthday or something. And so they temporarily moved the Mona Lisa to another part of the museum, and it was even more difficult to access the painting. So we had to go up like 4 escalators, and this is the only way to get up. So this was in a line of hundreds of people. We pretty much were pushed like cattle going up these escalators and then going through this long, windy hall to get to the point where we could finally see the painting. And when we finally got in front, we were pretty far away. I mean, it's pretty small considering how far back we had to stand. And the funny thing is, I mean, it's funny to me that everybody who goes there, instead of just standing and looking at the painting, they take a picture with their phone, which I have to admit I did too, but I did that when we were farther back in the line and I just zoomed with my phone. So that way, when we actually saw the painting, I could just stand there. But they gave us literally 60 seconds to stand and look at the painting. And the guard kept saying, just take your photo and leave. And Antonio said, I don't want to take a photo. I actually just want to look at the painting. And I think it was kind of funny when you said that. The guard actually kind of let his guard down a little bit. Yeah, I think you brightened his day a little bit when you said that. Because I think he was surprised that a tourist would want to come and actually see the painting and not just take a picture. But anyway, this is a very high-energy tune that I wrote about the Louvre. And it kind of reflects that feeling of when we were kind of being herded like cattle into that Mona Lisa wing. But aside from that, we really had a wonderful time there. And this composition is kind of inspired by the pianist Bud Powell, who was one of the great bebop pianists. And it's also inspired by the pianist Kenny Barron, a wonderful jazz pianist who's on the scene today. And I know that he was also very much inspired by Bud Powell. And I also know that Bud Powell used to live in Paris at some point in his life. So it's kind of appropriate to style this tune after him. So this is Louvre Groove. We hope you like it. That was an original composition called Louvre Groove. And I just saw a comment from our friend Bruno in Paris. Thank you so much for listening.
Yeah.
I don't know if you heard the beginning of this tune, or I don't know how long you've been watching this, but just in case you missed it, that's Louvre Groove. We're doing a whole new album of music all about our Paris trip from last summer.
He took the picture, right?
Yeah, he took the pictures at the canopy.
Beautiful.
So yeah, we love your photos so much. Everybody, go check out Bruno. I'm so sorry. You're going to have to correct me on the pronouncing of your last name. Is it Chavaret? You can leave a comment and let me know if I pronounced it correctly. Bruno is a wonderful jazz photographer, and he took some photos when we performed at Le Canapé restaurant in Paris last summer. And that's actually one of the tunes that we'll be recording on our album. It's a piece called Le Canapé. So we will definitely send that
Gwendol
to you when it's done. Yeah, if you're with Gwendol, please say hello. So we got just a couple more tunes to share with you tonight. And this one is by my all-time favorite pianist, Oscar Peterson. And there's a great story behind this piece. The name of the composition is Hymn to Freedom. And I always thought, oh, what a beautiful composition. It must have taken him a long time to write. I mean, not because it took Oscar Peterson a long time to write something, but it just sounds like a very well thought out piece of music. It's just got a melody and chords that just meld together so perfectly. I imagine that he probably, you know, spent a meticulous kind of amount of time working on it. But I learned that actually, when they were recording the album Night Train, Oscar Peterson Trio, their producer, Norman Granz, they were recording the record, and they had some extra time on the B side of the record, and they needed to play one more tune. So Norman just said, Oscar, is there another tune that you can play? And so apparently he actually just made up this tune, completely improvised on the spot. And what's amazing is that all three musicians played it together, Ed Thigpen on drums, Ray Brown on bass. And the recording just sounds like they had already been playing it together for years. You never would have known that they just played it together for the first time right at that session for that very record. So I just thought that was such an amazing story and such a testament to the musicianship of Oscar Peterson and his trio, because it really takes a special talent to be able to do that so quickly. So we just love playing this piece, and for some reason it seems like a nice piece of music for this time. It's kind of reflective, gives me a little hope that maybe we'll all get through this coronavirus sooner than later, and hopefully we'll all be out enjoying the great outdoors and spending time together soon. But for now, at least we can spend time together over the internet. Anyway, hope you enjoy Hymn to Freedom. Thank you. that was called Hymn to Freedom by the great Oscar Peterson. We've got one more tune to play for you tonight, and just a couple things I'd like to say before we go. First of all, thank you all so much once again for tuning in. If you haven't left a comment, please do. Feel free to say hello. Feel free to share this video if you enjoyed it. And also, if you need some more music to get you through these next couple of weeks when you are just sitting at home, feel free to pop on over to lauradubin.com. You can order all of our CDs as digital downloads or as a physical product. But I know that in this day and age, the download is probably the easiest thing for you to do. You can listen to it on any device, anywhere in the world. So if you don't have our collection of albums yet, now's a great time to go and download them for yourself. And I would also like to say that just yesterday, I started teaching piano lessons through Skype and FaceTime. I teach piano lessons at a studio in Pittsburgh called Musically Fit. And obviously, since schools are closed right now, the piano studio is closed. However, 21st century technology is allowing us to continue lessons with the students one-on-one through FaceTime or Skype or any other video chat platform. And it's actually going really well. And it turns out it's a really fun way to teach. And everything seems to flow really nicely. So if you are interested in taking a lesson at all, I'm offering a free 15-minute demo lesson for anybody anywhere in the world, whether you're in Rochester or over on the other side of the world or the country, any other city. Any other planet, exactly. And again, if you are on another planet, please let me know how you got there, because we might like to come visit you up there if this coronavirus sticks around for a long time. So anyway, if you are interested in a free 15-minute demo lesson, feel free to leave a comment, and you can also send me a private message through Facebook if you prefer, and we will talk about how to do it. So once again, as you know, we're Laura Dubin and Antonio Guerrero. Thank you so much for listening. Hope you all have a wonderful night, and we're going to finish out with another original composition of mine that I wrote when I was in the middle of making dinner one night. This is called Something's Cookin'. Thank you. Thank you so much for listening. Hope you have a wonderful night. Stay safe and healthy. And we will see you again when we're back here tomorrow night. Thank you. Bye.